soul mates. 20 years older than me, he was still a big kid.
Nice.
Well, it's all gone now, of course, the money, the jewels.
What happened to him?
6 months after Dean died, his business partner, Mike Barnes, offered me the chance to buy him out. His share of Lazy Palms for £1, I thought it was the most wonderful gesture. I trusted him. He was best man at the wedding, so I signed the papers. I found out later that on the day of Dean's funeral, Mike had mortgaged the lot. Once it was all unravelled, there were just debts, not assets. About £2 million worth, to be precise. It completely wiped me out. So, thanks to Mike's creative accounting, I'm stuck here in glamorous Kilburn. What made you decide to reopen the case?
A new witness came forward. She said she saw a man trying to barge into the house the night that Dean died.
In the original police report, it says that you spent the night with your mother.
That's right. She was sick. Come home the next morning and I found him.
He didn't leave a note?
No, well, I've always wondered about that because it seemed a bit wrong somehow. You said she, the witness, was a woman?
Yeah.
Who?
I'm afraid we can't tell you that.
You can't see the front door from the street, so she must have been in the grounds. What was she doing there? Please, I need to know.
The witness was an escort.
She was in the house.